students, welcome back to our channel. In this video, we're gonna talk about rational algebraic expressions. So first, what is rational algebraic expressions? So it is a fraction whose numerator and denominator are polynomials. It can be written in the form of p over q, where p and q are both polynomials and q is not equal to 0. So when we hear the word polynomials, it is a series of terms joined together by addition or subtraction. So here, p is our numerator and q is our denominator. So it can be monomial consisting of one term, binomial consisting of two terms, it can also be a trinomials consisting of three terms, and the other polynomials consisting of four or other terms. And always remember that the denominator is not equal to 0 because any number divided by 0 is undefined. So I have here some examples of rational expressions. So first, 3x squared plus 2x minus 4 all over 4x minus 5. Second, 3x squared over 4. Third, 4x plus 3y all over 2x squared minus 3xy plus 4y squared. So now I have here an activity, and from the given expression, let's identify whether it is a rational algebraic expressions or non-rational algebraic expression. So I will be giving you time to think for your answer. So first, x squared plus 5 over 2. Our first expression, is this an example of a rational algebraic expression? Alright, yes, it is an example of a rational algebraic expression. How about 3x over 8? Yes, it is an example of rational algebraic expression. Now let's proceed to m plus 2 over m raised to 1/4. This is not an example of rational algebraic expression. How about c raised to the 4th power over square root of 5x? Alright, not rational algebraic expression. How about h raised to the 4th power? Alright, it is an example of rational algebraic expression. And last, k over 3k squared minus 6k. Alright, this is an example of a rational algebraic expression. So in our activity, you have classified rational algebraic expression and not algebraic expressions. So for you to easily identify it, I have some things to remember. So a given expression is a rational algebraic expression if it is, first, algebraic fraction that has polynomials on both numerator and denominator. Second, no fractional exponent. Third, no negative exponent. Fourth, no radical sign or expression. Now let's proceed to simplifying rational algebraic expressions. So let's simplify the following. I have here 10 over 15. So how do we simplify this fraction? By getting its lowest term. So first, we have 2 over 3. Second, 12 over 16. The answer is 3 over 4. How about 3 over 12? Alright, the answer is 1/4. Now, in simplifying a rational expression, it means writing it in lowest term or simplest form. And for you to easily simplify a rational expression, you just only need to completely factor the numerator and denominator. And apply the fundamental principle of rational expressions to eliminate common factors in the numerator and denominator. And always remember, only common factors can be eliminated from the numerator and denominator. Make sure any expression you eliminate is a factor. Let's take an example. Let's simplify the following expressions. So first example, 9x squared yz over 24xyz squared. So first step, we need to completely factor the numerator and denominator. And since 9 over 24, we can easily simplify it by getting its lowest term. The answer is 3 over 8. Next, x squared over x. So the factor of x squared is x times x. Since we have 1x in our denominator, we need to eliminate the common factor. So we have here x. And then we have a common factor, which is y. So we need to eliminate this. And z over z squared. So we have z in our denominator. So the answer is 3x over 8z. Next, 60a squared b over 10ab. So first, we need to completely factor the numerator and denominator. And we can easily simplify 60 over 10 by getting its lowest term. So the answer is 6. A squared over a, the answer is a. And we need to eliminate b since we have a common factor. So the answer is 6a. Third example, we have 6a squared b over 18ab squared. So first step, we need to completely factor the numerator and denominator. And then second step, we need to eliminate the factors that are common to the numerator and the denominator. So the answer is a over 3b. Next, 10a cubed b over 12ab squared. We need to factor the numerator and the denominator. And then we need to eliminate the common factors. The answer is 5a squared over 6b. Next example, 3x squared plus 9x over 12x cubed. So we need to factor it. So what type of factoring are we going to use here? So we're going to use factoring with common monomial factor. We need to get the GCF to get the other factor. So we have 3x times the quantity of x plus 3 over 12x cubed. We need to get the lowest term of 3x over 12x cubed. So the answer is x plus 3 over 4x squared. Next example, x minus 2 over 2 minus x. So observe the given expressions. If you can see here, the numerator and denominator are opposite. They differ only in their signs. So what we're gonna do is to multiply negative 1 times the quantity of 2 minus x to make our numerator and denominator the same. So negative 1 times the quantity of 2 minus x over 2 minus x. So the answer is negative 1. So again, the numerator and denominator are opposites or additive inverses. They differ only in their signs. Next example, y squared plus 5x plus 4 over y squared minus 3x minus 4. Again, we need to completely factor the numerator and denominator. So what type of factoring are we gonna use here? We're gonna use factoring general or quadratic trinomials. So y squared plus 5x plus 4, the factors is y plus 4 times the quantity of y plus 1. And y squared minus 3x minus 4, the factor is y minus 4 times the quantity of y plus 1. So we need to eliminate the common factor. So the answer is y plus 4 over y minus 4. Next, x squared minus 9 over x squared minus 7x plus 12. So what type of factoring are we going to use in our numerator? So in our numerator, we're going to use factoring the difference of two squares. So we have x plus 3 times the quantity of x minus 3. And for our denominator, we're going to use factoring general or quadratic trinomials. So we have x minus 4 times the quantity of x minus 3. So we need to eliminate the common factor. So the answer is x plus 3 over x minus 4. For our last example, I have here 2x squared plus 4x plus 2 over 3x squared plus 6x plus 3. Again, we need to factor the numerator and denominator. And what type of factoring are we gonna use? The common monomial factor, or by getting its GCF. So the factor of our numerator is 2 times the quantity of x squared plus 2x plus 1. And for our denominator, 3 times the quantity of x squared plus 2x plus 1. Again, we need to eliminate the common factor. So the answer is 2 over 3. So thank you so much for your listening. I hope you learned a lot from our lesson for today about simplifying rational expressions. Thank you so much and have a good day.